Good morning and welcome to our communion service this morning. We're very pleased to have Jane Winter here to take our service, so welcome to you, Jane, again. We'll just start with the announcements. As far as singing is concerned, the congregation can sing the hymns, but you're asked to keep your masks on. The rules say the choir can take theirs off. The harvest service and lunch next week starts at the slightly later time of 10:30. You can come at 10, but we'll have to wait for a little while. The reason for that is we've got the harvest lunch, which will be at 12 o'clock. We'll be collecting for Bromley Food Bank, and they have a specific wish list. There's a note on the table by the door. So the harvest lunch will be at noon. All are welcome. It will cost £6 per person. Under 10s are free. So you can bring all your grandchildren or young children. All proceeds go to the Diocese Poverty and Hope Appeal. So if you're coming, could you please fill in the sign-up sheet in the church or email Jackie McCampbell, she's here today, and tell her if you plan to attend, which will make catering for an unknown number less of a challenge. The Christmas cards in aid of the leprosy mission are now available for purchase at the back of the church. The Chelsfield Volunteer Community Cafe is now a regular event on the first and third Wednesdays in the month between 2:30 and 4:30 in the village hall. Particularly for those who feel isolated, all are welcome. Transport can be provided, and if you need that, then speak to Caroline Davis. Any items for the October Parish Magazine should be with Barry by the 29th of September. Also, World's End Music, there are concerts next week by the London Classical Musicians at St. Mary's Green Street Green. And that's next weekend. You can pick up a flyer in the porch or see Philippa for more information. And on Saturday, they're doing the Four Seasons. The St. Martin's Toddler Group is up and running again in the Brass Cosby Room on Tuesday between 10:30 and 12 noon, £2 per child or baby, and that includes refreshments and craft resources. So that is already running, and the next one is this coming Tuesday. I think these are all the announcements. So we are here because we share a common faith. God the Father created us. God the Son, Jesus Christ, makes us whole. God the Holy Spirit strengthens us. And we start our service with the first hymn, 769, Through All the Changing Times of Life.
Thank you.
Let us remember the things we haven't got right and saying together, Dear God, we are sorry that sometimes we do things without thinking about others or about you. We get things wrong, we make mistakes, we forget to do good. Forgive us, loving Lord Jesus. Jesus knows what it is like to be a child like us and loves us, even when we are making mistakes. We are forgiven. Amen. Please be seated for the first reading.
Preceded by the collect.
For today. So we pray. O Lord, we beseech you mercifully to hear the prayers of your people who call to you. Grant that they may both perceive and know what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to fulfill them, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The New Testament reading is taken from James chapter 3, reading from verse 13. Who is wise and understanding among you? Show by your good life that your works are done with gentleness, born of wisdom. But if you have bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not be boastful and false to the truth. Such wisdom does not come down from above, but is earthly, unspiritual, devilish. For where there is envy and selfish ambition, there will also be disorder and wickedness of every kind. But the wisdom from above is first pure, then peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruits, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And a harvest of righteousness is sown in peace for those who make peace. Those conflicts and disputes among you, where do they come from? Do they not come from your cravings that are at war within you? You want something and do not have it, so you commit murder. And you covet something and cannot obtain it, so you engage in disputes and conflicts. You do not have because you do not ask. You ask and you do not receive because you ask wrongly in order to spend what you get on your pleasures. Submit yourself therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Here ends the reading. We now have the second hymn, hymn number 499, Make Me a Channel of Your Peace.
Thank you.
Lord. They went on from there and passed through Galilee. Jesus did not want anyone to know it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The kingdom of the Son of Man is to be betrayed into human hands, and they will kill him. And 3 days after being killed, he will rise again." But they did not understand what he was saying and were afraid to ask him. Then they came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they were silent, for on the way they had argued with one another about who was the greatest. He sat down and called the 12 and said to them, "Whoever wants to be first must be last and the servant of all." Then he took a little child and put it among them, and taking it in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes not me, but the one who sent me." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. I speak and may we respond in the name of God, who is Creator, Redeemer and Sustainer. Amen. Please be seated. It's very good to be with you this morning. Thank you so much for your welcome. It was wonderful to walk into church, not just to see the flowers, but to smell them. They're just absolutely gorgeous, and it's lovely to be here with you all. Well, the government reshuffle took me by surprise. I don't know about you, I've clearly been missing quite it wasn't just me. I thought I'd missed an awful lot of news. The first I knew about it was the 6 o'clock news driving home, and then I watched the 10 o'clock news. The stories of promotion and demotion got me thinking about leadership. Pure, peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruit without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. I wonder. And the leadership theme continued during the week. On Friday, along with many others, I received voting papers for General Synod. As a clergy person, I get all the manifestos from the clergy colleagues willing to stand for our diocese to shape the future of the church. Lay members of deanery synods will also have received manifestos from lay candidates for our diocese. A lot of people, lay and ordained, are willing to stand this time round, possibly because of the debate to be had next summer about marriage, relationships and sexuality. The business of synod is much more than that, important though that issue is. The stories of each candidate got me thinking about leadership. Pure, peaceful, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruit, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. 2 weeks ago, a group of lay people selected to train for licensed lay ministry met together to begin a module on Christian leadership. They are a very diverse group of people from all walks of life, bringing all sorts of experiences to the church. Praise the Lord for them. They and others who have gone before them got me thinking about leadership. Pure, peaceful, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruit without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. And just 3.5 weeks ago, many of us were here to welcome Michael at his licensing. Guess what? Leadership. Guess what? That same list. Pure, peaceable, gentle, willing to yield. I won't go on. Today's readings really speak into all of those situations and many more where leadership features for good or not so good. Now we know there are many different styles of leadership and they're all used in many different circumstances. And some of these benefit, so many benefit nations, workforces and families. But we are aware, aren't we, how often leadership benefits the leader or the group of leaders and not those that perhaps they are called to lead. We've seen rather a lot of that recently. We could say the test of a good leader is how they lead to improve the lives of those who are marginalised, which is what Jesus was talking about. It is a really good question and one that can be used politically, economically, socially, and one that can be asked of the church as well. You will probably know there are myriad manuals and courses for people who want to improve their leadership skills. Many are meant very good, and I know I've benefited from them. But the ones that are most highly rated, surprise, surprise, are the ones who talk about serving, the service of leadership. And James gives us that wonderful, challenging list in his letter about the characteristics of leadership. The wise leader is pure, peaceable, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruit, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. Jesus put it more simply. He said, those who would be first must be last, and the servant of all. And then he demonstrated what he meant by having a child in front of those disciples. We rate children very highly, and rightly so, in our society. But in Jesus' society, children, along with women, along with those who were sick, were the marginalised. Jesus is saying, those who lead make the marginalised their priority. When Jesus picked his disciples, he chose a motley crew, didn't he? An unlikely band of leaders in anyone's book, and yet his choice transformed the world. We talk more about them probably, and they are better known than some of the other world leaders that we have heard. And sometimes his teaching about leadership was hard to hear. I bet they were squirming in their boots when they heard that actually to be great, you have to be the servant of all, not the model many of our leaders follow. And I'd like to suggest that we all are called to Christian leadership. Panic not, I'm not suggesting you all have to get dressed up like this and stand at the front. That's not what I mean. But we are called as disciples, just like that first motley crew. We are called to follow Jesus. We are called to lead by the example of servanthood. We are called to live out our lives so that others see something of Jesus' love for those who are marginalised. We are called to have those qualities that James gives us, that through our decisions, our conversations and the actions that we do day by day, people may see something of God's purity, peacefulness, gentleness, God's willingness sometimes to yield, God's grace of mercy and goodness, God's good fruit without trace of partiality or hypocrisy. It all comes from God. It is a challenging list, but it's God who wrought that leadership in us, not we ourselves. Jesus still calls disciples, those who will live out his teaching in this time and in this place, pure, peaceful, gentle, willing to yield, full of mercy and good fruit, without a trace of partiality or hypocrisy. It is a strange kind of manifesto, but it's the one that has transformed and continues to transform the world. Will you put your name to it and follow where Jesus calls? Amen.
We now stand to say together the Creed. Do you believe in God the Father, creator and sustainer of the world?
God of the universe, Jesus Christ, who is one, Holy Spirit, power of God, hallelujah, free and one.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, who died and rose to be the Saviour of the world?
We pray for world leaders and all who are one, environmental debates and decision making. We pray for those who have stepped up in leadership to campaign to save our world. We pray that their influence will not only change hearts and minds, but bring forth right decisions to bear. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give thanks to God for the starting again of so many community activities. And we give thanks for those leaders who give of their time and of their talents to ensure these activities can benefit so many. We pray for the activities of our villages. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we hold before God those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. We pray for those who are still anxious about leaving home because of the virus. For those who are anxious about returning to work and travelling because of the virus. And we lift into God's presence those who are personally known to us, for whom we have promised to pray, including David Lane. Healing God, pour your blessing on those whom we have named. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Eternal God, we thank you for the gift of your eternity, for the knowledge that death does not separate us from love in Christ Jesus. Enfold in your welcoming embrace those who have recently died, those who will die today, especially those who will die by their own hand or who have no one to pray for them. Comfort those who mourn with your gentleness and with your peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, as we know you call us and as we seek to follow, so we pray for one another, that in these days to come, our lives, our words, our actions, our prayers, may demonstrate your love, that your purity, that your peace, that your gentleness may grow in us, and that others may be touched by your love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Would you like to stand for the peace? Jesus didn't promise an easy peace, but he promised a lasting peace. So may the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And
we share the peace in whichever way you share the peace. Peace is a good way of sharing the peace. Peace.
And so we come to remember Jesus, to remember all that he did for us, and all that he invites us to share with him. The Lord is here.
It's
here. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Lord of all life, you created the universe where all living things reflect your glory. You give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and to cherish. You give us happy times and things to celebrate, and in these we taste your kingdom, a feast for all your children. You make us all, each, wonderfully different, to join with the angels and sing your praise.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We thank you, loving Father, because when we turned away, you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." After they had eaten, he took the cup of wine. He gave thanks and shared it with his disciples, saying, "This is my blood, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this to remember me." So, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. Help us, Father, to love one another as we look forward to that day when suffering is ended, and all creation is gathered in your loving arms. And with St. Martin and all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ in the strength of the Spirit, today and forever. Amen. So joining with the whole family of the Church, we pray. Our
Father, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of us, now and forever. Amen.
The gifts of God to share among us. Though we are not, we are of him, because we will share our brethren. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have taught us through your Son that love is the fulfilling of the law. Grant that we may love you with our whole heart and our neighbour as ourself. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Go into the world as the loved children of God, precious to each other and to many people. May God, the God of grace, which watches over you, Jesus Christ, be your friend in every moment, and the Holy Spirit hold you close. Amen.
Our final hymn is hymn number 91, Brother, Sister, Let Me Serve You, the Servant Song.
We go in the name of Christ.
Amen.